Hi and welcome back. Today I will show you how to make Γλυκο Σταφυλι, a sweet of grapes, which is a Greek traditional treat that people offer their guests along with a glass of water, especially in the summer and especially in the islands. You will need seedless grapes, preferably. Otherwise, if they have seeds, you're going to have to take them out with a safety pin. It's a lot of work. So pick seedless grapes to begin with. So I have here 3 pounds of red seedless grapes, and I will pick them off the stems, make sure there's no stems left. Next, you wash them very, very well and make sure that you put your hands there and rub them and stir them until all the waxy stuff that they're covered is gone. Next, I put them in the strainer and let them drain. Actually, I give them an extra rinse just for good measure. And in the meantime, in a pot, I will heat up 2 cups of sugar, a little over 2 cups of sugar, and a little over 2 cups of water to make a simple syrup. So now I will turn on the heat, and when the water boils and the sugar has completely dissolved, I will add the grapes in the pot. Now I will give it a good stir, and I will add 1 teaspoon of whole cloves, like you see here, and 2 good-sized cinnamon sticks. Put them in there and mix it up, stir it, mix it up really good, and let it boil. Now while this is boiling, I'm going to cut 2 geranium leaves from my surviving plant in my living room, and I'm going to wash them really good, and I'm going to add them in the mix. That's really optional, so if you don't have geranium in your yard or in your living room, don't worry, it will still be good. As the sweet boils, the grapes seem to lose a little bit of their color, but the syrup turns a nice pink. You continue boiling it until the grapes start to look a little wrinkly, like you see here, and the syrup thickens. Like all sweets and marmalades, etc., remember to remove this white foam that forms at the edges of the pot all around. It's almost ready when the syrup thickens and the color turns darker and the grapes are a little wrinkly. To test if it's done, you put a little bit of syrup in a cold plate. I had this in the freezer. And you wait until it cools completely, and then you push it a little bit with your finger. It must wrinkle if it's ready. This needs a couple more minutes. Second test, this wrinkles, you see? So now it's ready. So now I'll put it in jars and tighten the lids. When it's cool, it's ready to serve. You put in a small plate a couple of spoons of this and serve it with a cold glass of water. This is a really delectable treat from the Greek kitchen. It's fragrant, sweet but not overpowering, and it tastes like summer. Another way to enjoy this confiture is as a topping on your favorite vanilla ice cream. It's a match made in heaven. You can also add it on top of your Greek yogurt along with some granola and almonds or pecans, and you have breakfast. Try it. And as always, thank you for watching and for subscribing. Have a great day.